नमस्कार दोस्तों, मेटलर्जी क्यूएनए में आपका स्वागत है। दोस्तों, आज इस वीडियो में स्टील मेकिंग का पार्ट 3 डिस्कस करेंगे। और दोस्तों, आप अगर इस चैनल में नए हैं तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर दीजिए और साथ साथ बेल आइकन को भी दबा दीजिए ताकि हर एक नया नया अपडेट आपके पास पहुँचते रहे। तो दोस्तों, टाइम वेस्ट ना करते हुए चलिए शुरू करते हैं। तो दोस्तों, आज का पहला क्वेश्चन है, कैप्ड स्टील इज एनादर वेराइटी ऑफ डैश स्टील। किस कील स्टील, सेमी कील, रिमिंग या नॉन ऑफ डैश। सही आंसर है ऑप्शन सी, रिमिंग स्टील। नेक्स्ट है दोस्तों, सेमी कील स्टील आर पार्शियली डी ऑक्सीडाइज स्टील, कॉन्टेन कार्बन इन द रेंज ऑफ 0.15 to 0.30% या आर यूज फॉर मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल शेप प्लेट एंड मार्जिन प्रोडक्ट या डी ऑल ऑफ एबव। सही आंसर है ऑप्शन डी, ऑल ऑफ एबव। सेमिकिल स्टील आर पार्शियली डी ऑक्सीडाइज स्टील, कॉन्टेन कार्बन इन द रेंज ऑफ 0.15 to 0.30% are used for manufacture of structural shapes, plates and margin product. So answer is option D, all of above. Next, kiln steel during solidification do not evolve gases, contain greater than 0.3% carbon, are cast in wide in-up mold with hot tops, yeah, D, all of above. सही आंसर है ऑप्शन डी, ऑल ऑफ एबव। कील स्टील ड्यूरिंग सोलिडिफिकेशन डू नॉट इवॉल्व गैसेस, कॉन्टेंट ग्रेटर देन 0.3% कार्बन, आर कास्ट इन वाइड इन अप मोल्ड विथ हॉट टॉप, डी ऑल ऑफ एबव। सही आंसर है ऑप्शन डी। नेक्स्ट है, द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ पाइप फॉर्मेशन इज मोस्ट सीरियस इन द केस ऑफ डैश स्टील, कैप्ड कील, रिमिंग या सेमी कील। सही आंसर है ऑप्शन बी, कील स्टील। द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ पाइप फॉर्मेशन इज मोस्ट सीरियस इन द केस ऑफ कील स्टील। नेक्स्ट है, वॉल्यूम कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ड्यूरिंग सॉलिडिफिकेशन ऑफ स्टील रिजल्टिंग इन पाइप फॉर्मेशन इज अबाउट 10% of the total apparent volume of the ingot. Say answer is option B, 2.5 to 3%. Volume contraction during solidification of steel resulting in pipe formation is about 10% of the total apparent volume of the ingot. Say answer is 2.5 to 3%. Next, primary pipe formation in ingot reduce the steel yield on rolling, does not weld during rolling, yeah, both A and B, yeah, neither A nor B. Say answer is option C, both A and B. Primary pipe formation in ingot reduce the steel yield on rolling and does not yield during rolling. Say answer option C. Next, blowhole formed due to entrapment of gas evolved during solidification of steel are not formed in dash steel, capped, kill, semi kill, or reaming. Say answer option B, kill steel. Blowhole formed due to entrapment of gas evolved during solidification of steel are not formed in dash steel. Say answer option B, kill steel. Next, segregation which can be minimized by prolonged soaking of ingots before working means departure from average composition increases with increasing time of solidification for an ingot. Yeah, tendency is more in large ingot compared to small one, AD all of above. Say answer A, option D, all of above. Segregation which can be minimized by prolonged soaking of ingot before working means departure from average composition increase with increasing time of solidification for an ingot. Tendency in more enlarged ingots compared to small one. Say answer A, option D, all of above. Next, segregation is maximum in dash steel, kiln, semi-kiln, coped, or reaming. Say answer A, option D, reaming. Segregation is maximum in dash steel. Say answer A, option D, reaming steel. Next, vacuum deoxidation of steel for achieving high degree of cleanliness is necessary for dash steel. Say answer A, option D, all of above, ball bearing, die and tool, and aircraft. Option D, vacuum deoxidation of steel for achieving high degree of cleanliness is necessary for dash steel. Say answer, option D, ball bearing, die and tool, and aircraft. Next, nitrogen in steel makes steel strain brittle. Poses problem in its cold working without intermediate annealing. Yeah, must be less than 0.002% in deep drawing type steel. Yeah, D, all AB and C. Say answer A, option D, all AB and C. Nitrogen in steel makes steel strain brittle. Poses problem in its cold working without intermediate annealing. And must be less than 0.002% in deep drawing type steel. Say answer A, option D. Next, nitrogen content in LD steel is minimum in case of dash steel, kiln steel, semi-kiln steel, reaming steel, or cap steel. Say answer A, option C, reaming steel. Nitrogen content in LD steel is minimum in case of dash steel. Say answer A, option C, reaming steel. Next, high hydrogen content in steel causes hair line cracking in fully kiln high alloy steel, reduce its ductility, yeah, both A and B, yeah, neither A nor B. Say answer A, option C, both A and B. High hydrogen content in steel causes hairline cracking in fully kilned high alloy steel, reduce its reducibility. Next, source of hydrogen pickup in steel making are wet or rusty scrap and wet solid charge material, steam fed into the furnace, wet refractory channel runner vessel, etc. Say answer A, option D, all of above. Sources of hydrogen pickup in steel making are wet or rusty scrap and wet solid charge material, steam fed into the source furnace, wet refractory channel runner vessels, etc. Say answer A, option D, all of above. Next, vacuum degassing of steel is done to remove hydrogen from steel to avoid prolonged annealing treatment, particularly in forging quality steel, improve cleanliness by removing oxygen in the form of CO gas, produce very low carbon steel, less than 0.03%, by transforming part of the refining from the furnace to the degassing unit, yadi all of above. Say answer A, all of above. Vacuum degassing of steel is done to remove hydrogen from steel to avoid prolonged annealing treatment, particularly in forging quality steel, improve cleanliness by removing oxygen in the form of CO gas, produce very low carbon steel, that is less than 0.03%, by transform transferring part of the refining from the furnace to the degassing unit. Say answer option D, all of above. Next, continuous casting of steel is not practiced at DS steel plant. Bhilai, Tata, Salem, or Bokaro. Say answer option C, Salem. Continuous casting of steel is not practiced at Salem steel plant. Next, the installed crude steel production capacity of Bhilai steel plant is 10 million ton per year. Say answer option C, 4.5 million ton per year. The installed crude steel production capacity of Bhilai steel plant is 10 million ton per year. Say answer 4.5 million ton. Next, the rated crude steel production capacity of Bokaro steel plant is 10 million ton per year. Say answer option B, 4 million ton per year. The rated crude steel production capacity of Bokaro steel plant is, say answer option B, 4 million ton per year. Next, continuous casting of steel increase the yield of finished steel product, produce the specific energy consumption in steel making, increase the production rate, D all of above. Say answer D all of above. Continuous casting of steel increase the yield of finished steel product, reduce the specific energy consumption in steel making, increase the production rate. Say answer option D all of above. Next, for effective removal of phosphorus in basic steel making furnace, the slag should have high basicity. Basicity of slag should not fall much low, otherwise phosphorus may revert back to the metal phase. Yes, see both A and B, neither A nor B. Say answer option C, both A and B. For effective removal of phosphorus in basic steel making furnace, the slag should have high basicity, and basicity of slag should not fall much low, otherwise phosphorus may revert back to the metal phase. Say answer option C. तो दोस्तों, आप अगर इस चैनल में नए हैं तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर दीजिए और लाइक और शेयर जरूर करिएगा. नेक्स्ट, इन स्टील मेकिंग प्रोसेस द रेशियो ऑफ फास्फोरस कंटेंट इन स्लैग टू दैट इन मेटल डेस ऑफ द स्लैग इज कॉल्ड डीफॉस्फोराइजिंग इंडेक्स. हैज ए हायर वैल्यू फॉर हायर बेसिटी या हैज ए हायर वैल्यू फॉर हायर ऑक्सीडाइजिंग पावर या डी ऑल ऑफ अबव. सही आंसर है ऑप्शन डी, ऑल ऑफ अबव. इन स्टील मेकिंग प्रोसेस द रेशियो ऑफ फॉस्फोरस कंटेंट इन स्लैग टू दैट इन मेटल डेस ऑफ द स्लैग इज कॉल्ड डीफॉस्फोराइजिंग इंडेक्स. हैज ए हायर वैल्यू फॉर हायर बेसिटी, हैज ए हायर वैल्यू फॉर हायर ऑक्सीडाइजिंग पावर. सही आंसर है ऑप्शन डी, ऑल ऑफ अबव. नेक्स्ट, silicon content in pig iron should be as low as possible during basic steel making process as it will reduce the lime consumption, slag volume, both A and B, or neither A nor B. Say answer A, option C, both A and B. Silicon content of pig iron should be as low as possible during basic steel making process as it will reduce the lime consumption and slag volume. Option C. Next, the solubility of oxygen in pure carbon during steel making at 1600 degree centigrade and 1800 degree centigrade are respectively 0.23% and 0.48%, 1.2% and 3.5%, 2% and 0.48%, 3% and 5%. सही आंसर है ऑप्शन ए, 0.23% एंड 0.48%. द सोलबिलिटी ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन प्योर carbon during steel making at 1600 degree and 1800 degree centigrade are respectively 0.23% and 0.48%. Next, which is the most effective and stable oxide used for oxidation of steel? SiO2, MnO, Al2O3 or TiO2? Sahi answer hai option C, Al2O3. Which is the most effective and stable oxide used for deoxidation of steel? Say answer option C, Al2O3. Next, phosphorus content in Thomas iron is -%. Say answer option C, greater than 1.5%. Phosphorus content in Thomas iron is greater than 1.5%. Next, tap to tap time in Bessemer converter is about 10 minute. Say answer option B, 20 to 30 minute. Tap to tap time at in a Bessemer converter is about 20 to 30 minute. Next, a flux added during smelting and refining reduce the softening point of gangue material, reduce the viscosity of slag, decrease the activity of some component to make it stable in the slag phase, yet D, all of above. Say answer option D, all of above. A flux added during smelting and refining reduces the softening point of gangue material, reduce have viscosity of slag, decrease the activity of some component to make it stable in the slag phase. Say answer hai option D, all of above. Next, dosto, which of the following is not used as a deoxidizer in steel making? तो इसका सही आंसर है ऑप्शन ए निकल. व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट यूज्ड एज ए डीऑक्सीडाइजर इन स्टील मेकिंग? सही आंसर है निकल. नेक्स्ट है, द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ स्टील मेकिंग प्रोसेस इज असेस्ड बाय द टेस्ट ऑफ स्टील यील्ड एंड क्वालिटी, प्रोडक्शन रेट, refractory consumption per ton, at D, all of above. Say answer is option D, all of above. The efficiency of steel making process is assessed by the days of steel, yield and quality, production rate, and refractory consumption per ton. Next, specific energy consumption in LD steel melting shop is about days G per calorie per ton of crude steel. Say answer is option B, 0.25 to 0.30%. Specific energy consumption in LD steel melting shop is about 0.25 to 0.30 G calorie per ton of crude steel. Next, LD converter employing suppressed combustion are not used at this steel plant. VIZAG, Bokaro, Selim, yeah, Bhilai. Sahi answer hai option C, Selim steel plant. LD converter employing suppressed combustion are not used at this steel plant. Sahi answer hai Selim steel plant. Next, during tapping of steel, dash are added in the teeming ladle, deoxidizer, recarburizer, alloying element, yeah, either of A, B or C. Say answer is option D, either of A, B or C. During tapping of steel, dash are added in the teeming ladle, deoxidizer, recarburizer, yeah, alloying element. Say answer is option D, either A, B or C. Next, during steel making, metallic loss causes due to the oxidation of metalloid and loss of iron in slag, loss of iron as fume and dust, and school formation on the mouth of the furnace, ejection as sloping and sparking. D, all of above. Say answer option D, all of above. During steel making, metallic loss occur due to the oxidation of metalloid and loss of iron in slag, loss of iron as fume and dust, and school formation on the mouth of the furnace, ejection as sloping and sparking. Say answer option D, all of above. Next, the lining life of steel melting converter is prolonged by doing hot repairs of the on out areas. It is known as fettling or gunning, ceramic welding, fettling, ramming. Say answer option A, fettling or gunning. The lining life of steel molding converter is prolonged by doing hot repair of the worn out tears. It is known as fettling or gunning. Next, the time required for converting a batch of raw material into steel, including handling time and time required for various repairs, that is fettling or the converter or furnace, is called the dash timing. Compagin, heat, tap to tap, both B and C. Say answer option D, both B and C. Heat and tap to tap time. The time required for converting a batch of raw material into steel, including handling time and time required for various repairs, that is fettling of the converter or furnace, is called the dash time. Say answer option D, heat and tap to tap time. Next, the duration before the steel melting furnace is due again for relining is called the dash time. Down, compagin, crack, tap to tap. Say answer option B, compagin time. The duration before the steel melting furnace is due again for relining is called the compagin time. Next, the main function of a hot metal mixture is to homogeneize the pig iron from various cast, heat up the pig iron, store the pig iron, conserve the heat of pig iron. Say answer option A, homogenize the pig iron from various cast. The main function of a hot metal mixture is to homogenize the pig iron from various cast. Next, Thomas process of steel making is another name of acid Bessemer process, basic Bessemer process, LD converter process, open heart process. Say answer option B, basic Bessemer process. Thomas process of steel making is another name of basic Bessemer process. Next, triplex process of steel making means that the same steel is processed successively in Bessemer open heart and electric furnace, three Bessemer furnace, three open heart furnace, three electric furnace. Say answer option A, Bessemer open heart and electric furnace. Triplex process of steel making means that the same steel is processed successively in Bessemer open heart and electric furnace. Next, Phosphorus occur in steel as Fe3P, FePO4, FeHolPO4Hol3, and none of these. Say answer A, option A, Fe3P. Phosphorus occur in steel as Fe3P. Next, maximum permissible percentage of phosphorus in plain carbon steel is -%. Say answer A, option B, 0.05%. Maximum permissible percentage of phosphorus in plain carbon steel is 0.05%. Next, presence of manganese in steel indicate it is good oxidation, decrease its tensile strength, result in blowholes, yeah, produce coarse grain structure. Say answer A, option A, indicate its good deoxidation. Presence of manganese in steel indicate its good deoxidation. Next, alloying elements are added to steel for improving high temperature strength and magnetic properties, increasing abrasion or corrosion resistance and the depth of hardening, refinement of grain size and high toughness, D all of above. Say answer A, option D, all of above. Alloying elements are added to steel for improving high temperature strength and magnetic properties, increasing abrasion or corrosion resistance and the depth of hardening, and refinement of grain size and high toughness. Say answer A, option D, all of above. Next, addition of aluminum to plain carbon steel increase its high temperature strength, help in its deoxidation, restrict grain growth, both B and C. Say answer hai, option D, both B and C. Addition of aluminum to plain carbon steel help in its deoxidation and restricts grain growth. Next, addition of cobalt to plain carbon steel help in making high speed steel, increase its red hardness, both A and B and either on or B. Say answer option C, both A and B. Addition of cobalt to plain carbon steel help in making high speed steel and increasing its red hardness. Next, which of the following alloying element when added to plain carbon steel increases its corrosion oxidation resistance? Say answer A, option A, chromium. Which of the following alloying elements when added to plain carbon steel increases its corrosion or oxidation resistance? Say answer A, option A, chromium. Next, which of the following alloying element when added to plain carbon steel does not increase its red hardness? Cobalt, molybdenum, aluminium, or tungsten? Say answer A, option C, aluminium. Which of the following alloying elements when added to plain carbon steel does not increase its red hardness? Say answer A, option C, aluminium. Next, presence of silicon in plain carbon steel is in the form of SiO2 is an indication of its poor oxidation, is in the form of Fe silicon, increase the blowhole formation tendency. Say answer A, option C, is in the form of FeC, ferrosilicon. Past presence of silicon in plain carbon steel is in the form of Fe silicon. Next, maximum permissible percentage of sulfur in plain carbon steel is 0.05, option B. Maximum permissible percentage of sulfur in plain carbon steel is option B, 0.05%. Next, sulfur occur in steel as FeS, MnS, both AnB, neither A nor B. Say answer option D, neither A nor B. Next, addition of chromium to plain carbon steel increase its corrosion or oxidation resistance, hardenability, high temperature strength, A, D, all of above. Say answer D, all of above. Addition of chromium to plain carbon steel increase its corrosion or oxidation resistance, hardenability and high temperature strength. Say answer hai, option D. Next, addition of nickel and chromium as alloying element in the plain carbon steel improves its strength and ductility, fatigue resistance, yeah, shock resistance, yeah, D, all of above. Say answer hai, option D, all of above. Addition of nickel and chromium as alloying element in the plain carbon steel improve its strength and ductility, fatigue resistance and shock resistance. Say answer option D, all of above. Next, temper brittleness of nickel chromium steel occur when it is cooled in air from the tempering temperature, thereby making it brittle. This can be eliminated by quenching the steel from the tempering temperature, small addition of molybdenum if air cooling is indispensable. Yeah, see both A and B, D, neither A nor B. Say answer option C, both A and B. Temper brittleness of nickel chromium steel occur when it is cooled in air from the tempering temperature, thereby making it brittle. This can be eliminated by quenching the steel from the tempering temperature and a small addition of molybdenum if air cooling is indispensable. Say answer option C, both A and B. Next, pick out the wrong statement. Tungsten percentage in steel varies from 1 to 20%. High speed steel after proper heat treatment possess red hardness. Main alloying element in high speed steel are chromium and molybdenum. A main alloying element in high speed steel are tungsten, chromium and vanadium. The same answer is option C. Main alloying element in high speed steel are chromium and molybdenum. Next, which of the following steel making process is generally not subject to acid and basic process modification? Bessemer converter process, LD steel making process, open hearth steel making, yeah, electric steel making. Say answer option A, Bessemer converter process. Which of the following steel making process is generally not subject to acid and basic process modification? Say answer option A, Bessemer converter process. Next, pressure of air blast introduced in Bessemer converter is about dash kg force per centimeter square. Say answer option B, 2 kg. Pressure of air blast introduced in Bessemer converter is about dash kg force per centimeter square. Option B, 2. Next, lining life of steel cell of Bessemer converter line with silica bricks is about dash heat. Say answer option C, 1800. Lining life of steel cell of Bessemer converter line with silica bricks is about 1800 heat. Next, life of the detachable bottom of the Bessemer converter made of siliceous vertical tires bricks is a dash heat. Say answer A, option B, 3 heat. Life of the detachable bottom of the Bessemer converter made of siliceous vertical tires Bricks is about 30 heat. Next, oxygen blow time in LD converter is about 10 minute. Say answer hai option B, 20 minutes. Oxygen blow time in LD converter is about 20 minutes. Next, addition of manganese to plain carbon steel increase its high temperature strength, hardenability, wear and abrasion resistance, yeah, oxidation resistance, yeah, none of these. Say answer option B, hardenability, wear and abrasion resistance. Addition of manganese to plain carbon steel increase its hardenability, wear and abrasion resistance. Next, blowhole do not occur in the dash steel. Kiln, rimming, semi-kiln, yeah, capped. Say answer option A, kiln steel. Blowhole do not occur in the dash steel. Say answer kiln steel. Next, which of the following alloying elements when added in plain carbon steel does not increase its hardenability? Molybdenum, vanadium, nickel, yeah, chromium. Say answer option C, nickel. Which of the following alloying element when added in plain carbon steel does not increase its hardenability? Say answer option C, nickel. तो दोस्तों आज के वीडियो में इतना ही, मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो में. जय हिंद.